G'day guys, it's Pete Moriarty here. I'm going to be taking you through my top five Chrome extensions that everyone should be using if you are a small business owner. These are going to make your day much more productive, going to help you out with some little tips and tricks. And if you're interested, we actually have a longer form version of this video, a whole 1 hour webinar on all of my favorite extensions. And I think I went through about 20 on that. That is inside our members area. So if you're interested in that, please go ahead and check out our website down below. There will be a link there to Concierge, where you can get access to all of our recorded webinars. Although, let's jump into the five that we've got for you today. If you're interested in Chrome plugins and Chrome add-ons, you get them all from the Chrome Web Store. And this is Google's marketplace for all of the Chrome add-ons. You'll see here that this is just a website, pretty straightforward, chrome.google.com/web store. And then you can browse through different lists of the most popular ones and you can search for them and find them. I'm going to share some of the ones that are my favorites. And from here on out, what you want to be doing from there is actually just installing them yourself. You can search for them in the web store. And I'm also going to drop the links to each one of these below. Now, some of these are changing right now, and that's because Google have actually changed how they are doing apps and extensions. The Google extensions that appear inside your actual menu bar inside of Google Chrome are staying for good. There is nothing changing about those. However, Chrome apps, which actually lived on the desktop and popped out in a separate window to your Google Chrome, are now being depreciated. There's new forms of web technology, which mean that Google are no longer using Chrome apps, which are like the separate standalone apps. These are now actually all being either extensions or web apps. And so if you're wondering where some of the old ones have gone, there aren't that many that are really gonna be missed because everything's kind of been rolled up into the new extensions menu. Okay, so let's go through some of my favorites. I'm gonna open up my list here. So the first add-on I wanna take you through is the biggest lifesaver add-on for me. And this is an absolute, absolute mandatory one for anyone who's working in the Chrome world. And this is called Clipboard History. And what this add-on will do is actually save you if you ever cut and pasted something and then let go of it or forgotten about it and you want to go back a couple of steps on your cut and paste history. This is effectively a history for your cut and paste, and it lives in your menu bar. And let me tell you, I use this probably 30 to 50 times a day. It is absolutely awesome. And so I can open up here, it's this little green icon here, and with one click, see all of my clipboard history. And so all of that history basically sits here automatically being saved every single time I copy something to my clipboard. So if I go and maybe copy over some text here, the Chrome Web Store, hit Control C for copy, you can see it's shown up there. And so every single time that I copy something, it's going to show up in my history, and Clipboard Web History saves it all. Now, not only does it do that, it's got a couple of pro features as well, which I've not actually used because they've only just released them, but you can click one button and actually have it saved to a cloud account, which will then synchronize between different machines. So that's useful if you've got multiple computers and you want to have your clipboard history move across the different computers. I think Macs do that nowadays, where you can have your history go from your phone over to your computer, and that's kind of useful. But where I find this really useful is where maybe I've got something saved in my clipboard history on my laptop, and I want to have it available on my desktop, and I'm using Chromebooks, obviously, so I want to have them available to me. So that one's called Clipboard History. Let me open that up for you so you can see the right one. Because there's a couple of these, and I want to make sure that you get the right one here. Here we go, Clipboard History Pro, that's the one. Cool, so it's at clipboardextension.com. Super, super duper useful. Now, some of the other features of Clipboard History Pro, you'll see here that once I've got something in my actual clipboard, I can star it to favorite it, and that's basically just never gonna allow it to erase. It does have a history function, and it will bit by bit delete the older entries. It will only save up to a certain number that you specify, but if you want to have something saved, then you just click it as a favorite. You can also click the send to mobile option here. So it was previously the Cloud Sync option, now it's sent to mobile. And what that one does is you do need to have the pro plan. I don't currently have that one, but that will then synchronize it between your different machines. So super simple implementation, super, super useful tool. This one was awesome. Then go ahead and write awesome down there. Next up, let's talk about one of the most important ones in your Chrome world, and that is your security. And we talk a lot about this plugin because it's absolutely essential for all business users to have a password manager. And our password manager of choice is LastPass. And so LastPass lets you share all of your passwords, so your secure passwords between your team, and without actually exposing the password, it will allow them to log into a website and get access to that site. So it might be, you probably wouldn't use it for WordPress, but any site or service that doesn't have the functionality of allowing you to actually share a login by creating multiple users, LastPass will allow you to save those passwords in a secure vault, and then in that secure vault, share out access to those websites without revealing the actual password. Now, the other cool thing that LastPass does is it will actually allow you to have a different password set for every different website that you use. And so for most of us, many of us will repeat and reuse passwords and they'll end up on multiple websites. And all it takes is for one of those websites to be hacked and then your password is all of a sudden exposed to the internet. And then what happens is someone grabs that password and they try it with your email address on all the different services, social media, your Google G Suite account, all the different services that you have online. And one by one, they may find their way into one of your accounts. And so using a tool like LastPass, which will generate a random password for every website that you use, will mean that things are actually kept nice and secure. So let's go ahead and have a look at what LastPass looks like. LastPass is just available on lastpass.com, and you can install the Chrome extension, which is going to sit here. So you can see it's a little red icon, sits up in my browser, and basically it lets me have one master password for every one of my passwords here inside of the password manager. Okay, so I've got a vault here, which actually stores all of my passwords. And from the vault there, all of my passwords are going to be saved and encrypted. But I've also got the option here to autofill websites and all those kind of things, makes that pretty straightforward. And then we've got, here it is, the password randomizer. Now I like to go to 20 characters for my passwords. It's just a little bit more secure, but basically all day long, you can generate new passwords for new websites, and they're the ones that you're gonna use as you go through to each one of your sites. Okay, cool. That is LastPass. With any one of your passwords, you can go ahead and click the share button and actually share that out to somebody else if you wanna share a password and share secure access to one of your websites. LastPass also have a great Teams feature. It costs a little bit of money, but you can get access to that through itGenius. And what the Teams feature will allow you to do is set up secured folders so that once you place a password into a folder, certain levels of staff will be able to get access to that. And so you can have a whole group of staff access a password. You can give different permissions, like maybe someone might want to have the ability to update passwords, but not necessarily kick you out as the admin. You can have different levels of hierarchy, and that works a little bit similar to Google Drive in the shared drives feature, where you can have different levels of access based on different level of kind of enterprisey permissions. So that's the LastPass Teams edition. And if you're interested in that, be sure to get in touch because we have discounts available for our concierge members. So we've done two out of three. Let's get into number three here. My third one is called Text Expander. This is another absolutely essential one. I use this every single day. And what Text Expander does is it gives you shortcuts for text. It's a little like automation kind of scripty app. And what it lets you do is get really, really smart when you're typing and using, let's say, repeated phrases. Now, if you've ever had something that you need to type frequently, and you may find yourself cutting and pasting those into Google Keep, or cutting and pasting them maybe from your clipboard history, or cutting and pasting them, maybe using like canned responses inside of something like Gmail, or if you're using Zendesk or Hiver, you might have some canned responses kind of set up. Text Expander will allow you to set little trigger phrases and trigger keyboard shortcuts and then automatically paste snippets of text. And what I love about that is it makes it really quick to get your work done if you're using repeated snippets of text that you actually need to paste and present. So let's open up and show you how to find the plugin in the Chrome Web Store just to make sure that you get the right one. Let's open it up here. It's called Text Expander. Okay, so this is the one that I like. It's called Auto Text Expander 2 for Google Chrome. Doesn't have an amazing Doesn't have an amazing rating there, but this one I've been using for years and years and works absolutely fine. It's also free, which we love. It's very hard to beat free. So let's open up my extensions here and open up my text expander, if I can actually find it. Here we go, auto text expander. Cool, all right. So I've got my text expander here, and you can see here that I've got a number of different shortcuts, and each one of those shortcuts just has a little bit of text here. And with that, I can automatically have that text expand into a note, which is pretty darn groovy. So let's go ahead and open up. I might do this using Google Keep, is probably the easiest thing to illustrate for you guys. All right, let's open up a new note here, and I'll see if I can make that a little bit bigger. Probably gonna help us. Excellent. All right, so I'm typing away. Here is my note, and let's just actually go to the text. I'm typing away my text note here, and let's say, for example, I need to put my signature in there. And I'm using an app that doesn't have a signature function. When we use Zendesk, or we previously used Zendesk for most of our ticketing, we've since switched over to Hiver for that. What we would do is we would need to actually paste our signature at the bottom of each one of those emails. And so I've got a little shortcut set up, which is actually Shift-1-2. So it's really easy to press on the keyboard. And Shift-1-2 will actually insert a signature. So you'll see there, you'll see the exclamation mark and then very briefly the at sign. I need to do it a bit faster. So exclamation mark, at sign, and then it automatically pre-fills with my details there. And so that's just happening because Auto Text Expander says that when I do an exclamation mark and then an at sign, it's gonna automatically drop in my signature. All right, let's have a look at another one. I've got one, and that is, I think I've forgotten the keyboard shortcut for it now. Oh, there we go, it's C at, okay, easy. So it's C and then an at sign, and then automatically it drops in my calendar link there. So that's another one that I've got set up. It's so baked into my mind when I actually use it, I forgot what the keyboard shortcut was. And so Auto Text Expander is gonna make it really easy if you've got like those little snippets of text that you need to paste from time to time. Makes it super easy to do it. It's a cinch just with a Swift keyboard conversation. One of the other ones that's actually like built in, which is pretty groovy, I think is BRB. Oh, does that one still work? No, maybe not. I think D and then at sometimes was date. No, it's gonna make a liar out of me. D, then the number 8. Okay, cool. So if I go D8, there we go. It actually puts the full date in there for you, which is pretty groovy. And so you can get kind of clever with some operators in there. It'll start to actually bring in other bits and pieces of functional data, and you can connect it to different apps, and there's all kinds of different bits and pieces that you can do. But honestly, I just use the simplest ones like my signature, and it is super useful. So that's Auto Text Expander, and that's gonna help you with your clipboard.